Hello guys, it's me, Ellen from The Winding Leaf, and today we are going to do another plant family themed plant tour. I decided to show you today all of my alocasias and their relatives, like the Homalomena and also the colocasia. It's behind me. Yeah, we have a look at all the plants I have from this plant group and how they grow and how to care for them. So here we have one of my most beautiful looking alocasias. It's a Alocasia zebrina. As you can see from the stems that have this very pretty pattern to it. And I just sprayed a little bit of water on her, so she looks even more pretty. And she's growing quite nicely. So sometimes she gets those like yellow spots for some reason, and also some of the leaves, you see those like lighter colored one, they will die soon, but this is normal. Yeah, so some, when a new leaf comes, sometimes the older leaves just yellow and die, so nothing to worry about. And here, fun fact, you see my Homalomena. I always refer to her as, she looks almost like a philodendron, but actually she is a sister. So this species is a sister to the alocasias and also to the colocasias and color lily and something else. Maybe I put it, if I think of something else, so I will put it in the description. So they all belong to the same plant family. Homalomena, zebrina. So, and here we have one of the biggest plants I have. It's a colocasia. It's also called elephant ear, elephantenohr, and or taro plant. And this is, as I said, not actually a alocasia, but a sister. They belong to the same species, to the same, I don't know, species. They belong to the same plant family and are different species. So there we go. Then we have this Lauterbachia, and Lauterbachia and I are most of the times on talking terms, but sometimes not. As you can see those like brown spots, she does not have a brown tip right now, but, maybe just a little bit like this. But this plant is very complicated. I just cut two of the big leaves that started to go yellow and flop. So this is very sensitive to over and under watering this plant. So now you have seen my zebrina and also this beautiful specimen here and my Lauterbachia. We are going to look at some more manageable, also from the size of the plant, plants that I can hold in my hand without having to rearrange my whole plant setup. All right, we start with this beautiful Alocasia poli, or Amazonica, or also called African mask, sorry. I'm sure lots of you have seen this plant, and maybe it was also one of the plants that got you interested in alocasias in the first place, because those leaves really look like nothing you had ever seen before when you were new to house plants and collecting them and becoming a crazy plant person, because you can't even believe that something like this exists and only costs like 19 euros or something. So mine is quite big, and she's growing nicely. The stems are very thick and juicy. That goes for all the alocasias, so they store a lot of water in those stems, and that's why it's also very important to get your watering schedule, the humidity right with those plants, otherwise they will just rot if you give them too much, or dry out if you give them not enough. So alocasias like to be in a moist soil almost all the time, but they don't want to get their feet too wet, then they rot, not too dry. So it's a little bit of a, you know, guessing, try and error game you have to engage in the beginning until you figure it out. And when you have your watering schedule, then, you know, it will be easy breezy. Now we see here in the background, Carlito is sitting in front of the window. Give me a second. I will let him come in. So Cat is here and quite irritated what's happening in his feeding spot. What is Frauchen doing here? Say hello. Guck mal. Spooky. All right, let's get back to the topic at hand. Okay, we had the Polly. Let's look at this beauty next. She is Alocasia Red Secret. And I just put the steak in here so she's not flopping down. This plant, let me find a nice angle. When she grows, looks like this. So it's very wobbly leaves that either go inside or outside, depending. I did not see, so they look all that, they look like in the end, like this. In the beginning they look like this. So nothing you see from our normal European plants. That's why they are very exotic and interesting for us, I would assume. Alocasia so their natural habitat is Southeast Asia and parts of Australia. This is where they're from. They are tropic or subtropical plants. That's why lots of humidity. I must say, for me, I don't put them in any special humidity corner or area. This is all reserved for my prized philodendrons, monsteras, and anthuriums. They are just standing normally, you know, where there's space. But what I do, I miss them. You should do it probably every day. I don't. I do it like when I remember. Once or twice a week, and also more for decorative reasons, so I can get rid of the dirt on the leaves, and they don't mind, so they don't complicate with that, except the Lauterbachia, but every other Alocasia I have is very easy to care for. Next we have Alocasia Stingray, and this is a plant I'm very excited for, that she grows up fast. I got her as a baby. And look, the leaves are, as the leaves, it's called Stingray for obvious reasons. And the leaves really look very alien-like and interesting. Stem is also speckled, and I cannot wait till she's, you know, big and tall and looks very architectural. So super cool plant in my opinion. Yeah, and then we have two little baby plants left in my Alocasia collection. So this is the Silver Dragon that I also got as, like, I would say half the size of this. She's standing under grow light and growing away. And as you can maybe see, yeah, there's also new growth coming. Looks healthy, thick, not floppy or nothing. So little terracotta pot like this, and under a grow light, you have to check. So every 2 days I put a little bit of water in, and you know, that seems to do the trick. By the way, some people like commenting that this white substance is because I have too much chalk in my water, because I water with tap water, and I don't think that's the case. I checked. I think it's the case because all of those plants were potted in new soil, and the new soil has lots of nutrients in it, and I think that's just the nutrients from the soil that diffundieren you would say in German, outside the pot also will be a little bit of chalk, but you know, I'm not worried about that. So the plants don't complain, it's all good. And if I have problems in 3 months because their mineral buildup is too high, then you can all tell me, I told you so. But until then, I'm not going to worry with distilled water. This is not going to happen. And yes, in spring, I'm going to try and install a rainwater thing because we have a big garden. So there is no reason not to put the rainwater, something, container, tonne. Yeah, I will look into that. And until then, tap water and, you know, call it a day. So, last alocasia for today is my black velvet alocasia. She's the alocasia that grows the slowest, so the slowest grower, but she also has a new leaf coming. And with alocasias it's like this, they have new leaves. If they grow, the older leaves that were smaller, you know, tend to die, so they just grow up and then forget about the rest. And this is normal, yeah. So it's not like a stem and then leaves, it's just each leaf is a fresh stem that comes out of the plant, you know. Yeah, what can I say? Black velvet, the name suggests it's a velvety leaf feeling. Very nice. yeah. I would say those are very good starter plants. When you want to expand into more exotic looking plants for yourself that don't break the bank, especially if you buy them as little babies that cost like online, I would say 5-6 euros. And then you can have the joy of seeing them grow, and also is good, you will already, you know, get your care down so you can experiment and see what is happening. Yeah, and they look impressive, especially for non-plant people, when they see a plant like this or a plant like this, or especially a plant like this, they say, oh my god, what's that? I've never seen anything like that. So you can impress people, you can make nice Instagram pictures, you know. And they are forgiving plants when you get the watering right. For watering, I would suggest the same as with my calatheas. I water them when they at 3 or 4 on the moisture meter. All right, lovelies, I hope you enjoyed my little alocasia video. I'm going to put everything back in their place now and look if I find any spider mites on my fiddly fig, because some viewer commented that the little brown spots, I show you in a second, that the little brown spots that I saw while I did my last plant tour with for all of you, that this might be spider mites and not irregular watering schedule, what I first, you know, thought could be the reason. Okay, so I will do that and let's hope for the best. So one viewer suggested that those brown spots are actually spider mites, but that they are very hard to see on the fiddly fig. So I'm turning the leaf around, this is how it looks from this side. I don't see anything, I don't see any white thing. It will probably really be irregular watering, what I don't know why, because I mean, I water this like all of my other plants with the moisture meter, but maybe it happened when they were still inside or something genetic, or I don't know. So let me know what you think. Yeah, that was it. All right, thank you for watching. And if you like the video, subscribe or share with friends that might be starting their plant journey, and you can be one of those people that gives too much information without being asked. So, you know, you can say it's my fault because I told you so. Okay, thank you. Bye bye and see you next time.